Well, let's talk about hope just for a minute. Hope is among a number of things that are part of the human toolkit, such as that if you were a hunter-gatherer and you were a depressed and unhopeful person, you would not bother getting up in the morning and going out to hopefully find a giraffe or something else that you might eat. So I think hope is built in unless people are suffering from clinical depression. You might even define that state as something's gone wrong with the hope. So we are all hopeful in that respect. What was it that Oscar Wilde said about a second marriage is a triumph of hope over experience? Do I hope that books are a way of helping people to think about the great big change we're all in the midst of? I think calling it climate change is rather limiting. I would rather call it the everything change. Because when people think climate change, they think, oh, maybe it's going to rain more or something like that. We can deal with it. But in fact, it's much more extensive a change than that, because when you change patterns of where it rains and how much and where it doesn't rain, you're also affecting just about everything. You're affecting what you can grow in those places. You're affecting whether you can live there. You're affecting all of the species that are currently there, because we are very water dependent. We're water dependent and oxygen dependent. And the other thing that we really have to be worried about is killing the oceans, because should we do that, there goes our major oxygen supply and we will wheeze to death. So those are the biggies, and it's not just maybe we'll get more rain. It's everything is changing in ways that we cannot yet fully understand or predict. It's rather useless to write a gripping narrative with nothing in it but climate change. Because novels are always about people, even if they purport to be about rabbits or robots. They're still really about people, because that's who we are and that's what we write stories about. So you have to show people in the midst of change and people coping with change, or else it's the background. So in the Mad Adam books, people hardly mention, quotes, climate change, but things have already changed. For instance, in the world of Jimmy, whom we follow in Oryx and Crake, the first book, as he's growing up as an adolescent, they're already getting tornadoes on the east coast of the United States, the upper east coast, because I like setting things in and around Boston. It's nice and flat. When the sea rises, a bunch of it will flood. You know, Back Bay isn't called Back Bay for nothing. It used to be a bay. So it's the background, but it's not in your face a sermon. So I think it's more like showing people in a setting. Anything about the future is going to do that. Show people in a setting that is not the same as the setting that we are used to. As I say, hope is built in. Yeah.